Welcome. In this video, we'll brew a deck that includes three things, big mana, so we'll have a lot of lands that produce tons of mana, we'll have X spells where we can put all that mana in, and we even have an alternate win condition called Helix Pinnacle. What's up, kitchen table wizards? What's up, deck brewers from all over the world? This time we are going to build a deck around X spells. Now, when I think about X spells, I mainly think about cards like this card. Now, what would happen if we make an X spell deck without red? I got you curious now. Good. This deck has a lot of different cards in it, so we always have fun and diverse games, and also to give you some inspiration for your deck brewing. Now, before we jump into the deck, a quick shout out to the best place where you can buy your Magic singles in Europe. That's Card Market. If you haven't tried it out, check out the link in the description below. I even have a 5 euro voucher for a first time user. And these nice people at Card Market,
they keep on throwing us vouchers that we can throw back to you.
That's correct, Nora. And the only thing you need to do is leave a comment and tell me which big X mana spell you like in your decks.
Now let's jump into the deck.
So this deck is about 40 euros. For some reason in dollars, apparently it's more expensive, but I still consider it a budget deck. Now, you know, if you watch the channel, that I like to brew and put in a blender old famous decks and put a special Bram sauce over it, make a nice casual budget version out of the deck. And this is what I did with this deck as well. I took a list called 12 posts with some special lands, and I used it to make a shell for our X spells deck. And this all will become clear in the mana base. So a big mana deck needs quite a bit of lands. I play 26 of them. Now, usually I would start with the flavor, with the basic lands, but this time I'm going to start with some very special lands. The Locust lands. We play 4 Cloud Posts, a land that comes into play tapped and provides us with 1 mana for each Locust in play. And then there's also Glimmer Post. This one gives us 1 life for each Locust in play when it enters the battlefield. I also play 2 copies of Thespian Stage, a land that can become any other land for 2 mana. So this means that we can have 10 Locust lands in our deck. Now, the original version is called 12 Post, so it has 12 Locust lands, or it can have 12 Locust lands in the deck because it also plays this card, but it's a bit more expensive. So let's keep it casual, let's keep it a bit budget, and let's call it 10 post. This is a 3 color deck in white, blue and green, so I also included 1 Seaside Citadel. I also include quite a bit of dual lands in the deck to give us some extra life. 3 Blossoming Sands, 3 Tranquil Coasts and 2 Thornwood Falls. For more mana fixing, I included this Skycloud Expanse and a Selesnya Sanctuary. Now, the last one is nice when you have a lot of Locust lands on the battlefield, especially when you can bounce and replay a Glimmer Post. Now let's head into the style of the deck and look at our basic lands. I only play 4 of them, and the lands I picked out symbolize the big mana with the mana symbols. So I play 2 Theros Beyond Dead Plains, 1 Forest and 1 Island. I also play 1 Balaghet Recovery, which is certainly not a land, but it can turn into a land, so I add it to our land count as well. Now, it's important to find our lands to get the most out of them, and for this I use a lot of mana ramp. First, with some creatures. Magus of the Candelabra needs some new clothes and a haircut.
So style-wise, he's out, if you ask me.
Yeah, that's true, but he also untaps a bunch of lands, so that's good, so he's in.
I'm not sure that the style committee would agree.
Okay, let's continue. So the reason I would put him in is that he can untap all our Locust lands and help us get to a ton of mana. Next up are the Voyaging Satyr and the Vizier of Tumbling Sands. You can play them early to chump block, or you can play them in the late game to generate a ton of mana with our lands. Next up is a creature that really loves X spells. Roisin Meanderer is a 4-4, which is decent, but it can also tap for 4 mana.
And we play almost 20 X spells, so for that reason this one can stay. But I'm still not sure about Magnus though.
Okay, to avoid further dress code issues, I won't be putting more creatures in this deck. The best way to our Locust lands is by using our treasure maps. And because we also have quite a bunch of spells that rather have a high color requirement, I also included this Gilded Lotus, which is very useful in the deck. Our three ramp spells are also X spells. I included one Animist Awakening and one Nylea's Intervention. This last one can also deal with flyers. And that's handy when your opponent plays a lot of flying creatures, like for example a bird deck. Yeah, exactly. Now I also play one card to fetch some more lands, and this card is called Sylvan Scrying, a very simple card that searches any land for you. Now on to some enchantments. Unbound Flourishing is not the cheapest card of the deck, but its effect is really special. When you cast a permanent with X in it, you double the amount of X, and when you cast a spell with X in it, you copy that spell. So this card is really amazeballs in the deck. Now in the intro, I talk about an alternate win condition. It's a card that needs 100 mana to win. The card is called Helix Pinnacle. It's a 1 mana enchantment, and it has Shroud to protect itself. And for a mana you can put a counter on it, and at the beginning of your upkeep, when the pinnacle has 100 counters, you just win the game. And with the Cloud Posts and the Mages of Cantelabra, I managed to do it in the second turn after I played this Helix Pinnacle.
I understand, we really need a homeless guy with candles in the deck, so let me clear it up a bit. This one is much better.
Okay, chairman of the style advisory board, I'm glad you approve. Now we do have a little bit more creatures, but they come in the form of tokens and they're quite stylish. Now let's first look at some cats that have instant speed. Now I don't think that our fluffy friend is part of the White Sun Zenith. I think he's very fluffy, but he does lack some speed, right Storm? So this card costs 3 white and X, and it will create a bunch of cat tokens. Decree of Justice brings us a bunch of angels. Or sometimes you can cycle it and you'll get some extra blockers in the form of 1-1 soldiers.
This is Sparta!
Another card like the Decree of Justice is this Starnheim Unleashed. For 11 mana you get 5 4-4 angels with flying and vigilance. And then, when you have Unbound Flourishing, you can copy it and get 10 angels. And that's 40 power in the air. Another big token maker is this March of the Multitudes. It brings us a lot of soldiers with lifelink. And now the most crazy X spell in the deck is certainly this Finale of Glory. It gets us both soldiers and angels, and getting to 12 mana with this deck is really a piece of cake. Now this is not really a fast deck, so we need a lot of removal to stop our opponent from attacking us with some creatures before we can get our combo online. Martial Coup is both an X spell that makes tokens and a removal spell, so a perfect card in the deck.
Right, Storm?
Fumigate can gain us back some life while destroying all creatures. and descent upon the sinful removes all creatures, which is great versus graveyard strategies. And we don't mind because we mostly have tokens anyway. I also included 3 copies of Quarantine Field. Very unflavor nowadays. And with all the mana, sometimes it's a sweeper for all your opponent's permanents. And because we have a lot of colorless mana in the deck, I also decided to include 1 Oblivion Stone. Now this big mana deck is also some sort of a control deck. So we need counter spells and card draw. Both Spellburst and Overrule are counter spells with X in their mana cost. Spellburst we can buy back to play again and again. And Overrule gives us a lot of life back. Tassa's Intervention can be used as a counter spell, but also as a card draw spell. And Strixhaven gave us this ingenious mastery. A card draw spell which we can also play for 3 mana with some downside. This is also an X spell I like to copy. Also from Strixhaven, multiple choice, scries, draws cards, bounces and creates a token. Another great card for our deck. The second finale we play is this finale of Revelation. Draw X cards and when X is 10 or more, shuffle your graveyard into your library, untap 5 lands and you have no maximum hand size for the rest of the game. And this will happen quite often in our deck. The last X card drawing spell is a tournament staple called Sphinx's Revelation. The card used to cost $20, but now you can pick it up cheap for just a few bucks. And it gains you life and draws you a bunch of cards. Now one more card to discuss and it's a Planeswalker. Nissa, Steward of Elements is a great card in the early game as it can help you scry for your Locust lands. And it could also act as a finisher with its ultimate ability. So a suitable Planeswalker in the deck. So this was the deck, give the video a like if you liked the video, but also leave in the comments below which X spell you would like to include. And before we announce the Card Market voucher winner, let's first look at some power rankings. No surprise that this deck can do powerful stuff. It's maybe a bit clunky, which also makes it a casual deck. We might even include it in one of our future gauntlets. Really aggressive decks probably will have the upper hand against this deck. But when the Locust engine is online, other decks will have troubles beating this big mana deck. Now on to the card market winner of the week. Congrats, Neon Grey. Check out the description below the video on how to contact us to claim your voucher. So this was my take on a big mana X spell deck. I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope to also see you in our gauntlet, our Magic the Gathering Fantasy League every Sunday. Now you still probably have some time until the next match, so until then, just keep it casual.